Hey Wildcats! This week for online learning, we're going to be talking about repetition. So repetition means to repeat something or do it over and over again. Artists do this in lots of different ways. So we're going to look at an artist and then we're going to create something using repetition. Let's get started. To help us learn about repetition, we're going to look at the artist M.C. Escher. These are a few of his artworks where he uses repetition of a single subject over and over again. Except the kind of repetition he uses has a special name. It's called tessellation. So tessellation is when you repeat, but there is no overlapping. That means no images go on top of one another and there's no spaces between those objects. Looks really complicated, but I'm going to show you an easy way that we can make our own tessellations. The materials we'll need are one large piece of paper, one small piece of paper, scissors, tape, and some drawing supplies. To start, we'll use the small piece of paper. It doesn't have to be a square, but it needs to be small enough that it can repeat inside of the larger piece of paper multiple times. First, I'll label the sides. So on the vertical sides, the ones that go up and down, I put them both as A, and the horizontal lines, the top and the bottom, I will put a B. That's gonna help us because we're going to cut apart this shape. On one side with an A, I'm going to draw a line. It doesn't matter what it looks like as long as it stays just on the A side. And then I'll do the same on one of the B sides. Just draw a line, making sure it only stays on that side of the paper. Then we're going to cut each one out. So first I'm cutting out the A side. Make sure that you're using one continuous cut so there are no scraps of paper. Then you're going to take that shape and move it over so that the A's are touching. The straight sides of the paper are touching, and then tape it together. And then we're gonna do the same with the B. So cutting it out, making sure that there are no scraps of paper coming off. If you make a mistake, just roll with it. And then we are going to slide it down so that the B's are touching on the flat side, and then tape it together as straight as you can. I'm going to use an extra piece of tape so that the whole thing is flat and it doesn't fall apart. Now it's time to get drawing. I'm going to take that shape and just place it anywhere on the paper, and I'm going to trace all around it. I'm making sure that I leave my shape in the same spot. It doesn't move while I trace all around it. This is important for the next part because we're going to take our shape and move it over, and it should fit together like a puzzle piece with the other side of the shape if you just slide it. I'm going to trace around it again and then keep on going across my paper. Once you've reached the other side, we can even keep going. So I'm going to take it and move it down, and the bottom of the shape above and the top of my stencil should match up perfectly. We are tessellating and repeating the shape. There's no spaces in between them and they fit together like a puzzle. When you're all done, you can color it in however you want. I hope you had fun tessellating, Wildcats, and I will see you next week.